Hey guys, your Broker Bears, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Liverpool Grammar, where last time I left off, I faced the most frustrating of opponents. A one-man team. And that man for that team was Sunderland's goalkeeper, Pantelimon. Oh... Okay, I got the result I wanted. Well, I got 3 points. 1-0 wasn't exactly the result I wanted, but I'll take it. In this episode, we are out of the transfer window, which, because of the lack of a second game before the window closed, was meant, and that was. All that was in the second half of the last episode, so sorry about only one match in the last episode. Hopefully that won't be the case again during any transfer window. Now I'm starting to think maybe I should have played that Super Cup match and then that the transfer window, the debacle wouldn't have mattered.
Premier League
action for Martin Tyler off camera. If that's the case in future seasons, I will have to play the Super Cup.
This is the Liverpool side. Rafael
Varane. In other news, Philippe Coutinho has become my fifth player who is 90 rated, joining Gareth Bale, or Marco, plays Neymar, and Ronaldo. They are now 90 rated or higher.
Those wide lads in the midfield do want to get forward.
I'm telling you, I'm getting closer to getting them all 90 rated.
Striker, we'll see.
How will Liverpool do today?
And there's a few other players who've gone up recently, like Nathaniel Klein is now an 86 rated player. Far cry from when we started, when he was 81.
And I don't foresee them slipping up.
Oh, in goes the cross.
And I noticed that Marc Laporte is falling a bit behind in the rings.
To Robertson.
He hasn't gone up to A5 yet, which
and the ball's got away from him.
Is a bit surprising.
Well, he could be in.
I'm not gonna get overly worried about his ring just yet, but if it doesn't go well, between now and January, I might put him into training for a bit, just to, help give him a little bit of a push. I mean, he's still one of the youngest players in my team, like, as well as for being my keeper and Tielemans.
Cristiano Ronaldo.
And, I figured out what was wrong with Tielemans. He didn't like being dropped for the Super Cup simulation. So, hopefully, a run of Premier League games will help get his morale back up. And, this is again why I stress that EA have to act. Had in some way of telling your player that you're only resting them for one game and it doesn't mean they've been dropped for the team and so they don't get it pissed off. Because it happens so often. I give them a few games off, a few games to rest, relax. The less important
it's just a throw after the
teams, and all of a sudden they think they're no longer in my plan.
And the ball's in. It's a goal! Off we go again, 2-1.
So, EA, fix that. Fix that now. That's annoying, that N'Golo Kante goal. I mean, he shouldn't even be at West Brom. He should be at Leicester or Chelsea.
Well, it will be a throw-in. Ronaldo. Shot up! Got in and blocked it. We're going to get a corner here because of that deflection.
Tillmans wins the corner.
That's really the way to get the ball.
In. It's going to come to Bale. He's going to lose it immediately to Berahino.
Fred.
Calm now. Calm.
James McLean.
Not in a situation where I have to get stressed just yet.
Quick tempo to the passing.
Although angry, angry I can get. Angry I can get. Timmons. Someone make a fucking run, please. Thank you.
Ronaldo looking for room in a wide position.
Ronaldo shrugs off the call it an attempted challenge. Timmons! Oh, Neymar! Is blocked. I don't know how much it's error. But it's still Karius in goal for West Brom.
Tries to punch it away.
I'm not going to talk about what happened to Karius during preseason because I don't need to be angrier. All I'll say is, can we just surrender our first few games until Karius is back, because we're going to lose him anyway with Mignolet in goal.
Strong, fair challenge,
and with all the defensive injuries that we're getting. And this is not excuses, I'm just telling the truth. Our defense is going to be absolute shambles. Our defense is probably worse now than it was last season. Because we've signed one improvement. Well, two improvements. You almost forget Matip signed because he played one game, got injured.
Two added minutes. Oh, he's through. Neymar! Oh, great work by the keeper.
I mean, like I said, I'm not going to talk about it too much because it'll just drive me up the wall. I need to focus on the game. 3-1 at halftime. Good lead.
And the second half gets
Cristiano Ronaldo and Philippe Coutinho brace. Is Ronaldo's fifth goal or is it sixth?
Conte.
Already this season. Looking to become the first player to win in this particular career mode for player to win the Golden Boot twice. Although Coutinho is going for that as well, because he won it before as well. I think. I still haven't checked that. I still have to go back and check that. I think he won it in season.
Goal from Cristiano Ronaldo, and he won't have scored many better than this in his career. He laced this into the top left.
Okay, so his first goal was his fifth, because that just said it. And his second was his sixth. So there you go. Now he's on six.
Victor Wanyama.
It's I think it was a Wolves player who was above him. I don't know how Wolves are getting on. I don't know. It didn't show them. It showed the other scores. So either Wolves have already played, or they haven't played yet.
We'll think just about in time.
Ew. We
going to be West Bromwich Albion to make the substitution.
That's
real good
for another time. We can check that in a minute.
Nathaniel Clark.
Sure, it's early days anyway, in terms of this season, and who's going to be top goal scorer.
James McLean. Well, that is a cheap piece of
Here's
play to
Bell.
Get the ball away like that.
Doesn't win the header.
Fred. That's a strong tackle right by the touchline. It's put the ball out for a throw. Neymar.
Neymar. Coutinho. Cristiano Ronaldo.
To play on the break.
He hit the bar! Are you kidding me?
Cleared it well.
I was getting ready to say, hey, no. Oh, it was 5-1, but he hit the bar. Damn it, Cristiano. A one time.
Coutinho.
My XP.
That's an easy interception.
Did well.
Because the pass wasn't.
Considering how many goals you score in real life and how many you scored last season. And I have very much right to consider you score. I mean, 39 goals last season. He's already got 6. He should realistically have 7.
Well, that's a good block. Well, they've got a corner out of that. A bit lucky. It was deflected.
I guess it's I guess it's not like it's important. I mean, I'm still going to win this match. Unless West Brom pull a huge amount of goals out of there.
Contest is long, long
Saka.
All credit
crap
to the team
that they
winning.
Pulled the
I'm afraid not too much credit
N'Golo Kante goal from.
Almost done now. 4-1. Time ticking away. So we can think about what this might mean for their next game.
Well, Liverpool go up against Stoke after this, Martin. And they have played well. They've stroked the ball around.
Rodriguez deals with that. Full attack.
That's going to be a free kick late in the game now.
Yeah. Yellow card. Come on. Referee. It's not like it's going to matter.
The goalkeeper with a textbook.
I'm pretty sure Tillman's won the header, but hey. If you say it's a. It was grabbed by my keeper. I'll believe you. Go for it.
Referee has chosen to add on 2 extra minutes. Cristiano Ronaldo.
Ronaldo. Not sure why. I don't know why I did that. There's the full-time whistle. 4-1. I'm disappointed with the goal conceded, but in the end, it didn't matter. Leicester beat Chelsea and Crystal Palace beat Watford. Actually, that removes Crystal Palace from the bottom of the league. Well, I had already done that anyway, because the trashing I gave West Brom would put them bottom anyway on goal difference, but Crystal Palace ensured it. And look who else they put into the relegation zone. That is an unlikely sight, isn't it? Everton, Man City, and West Brom. Imagine if that was the 3 teams that got relegated this up-and-coming season. How pissed would Man City fans be if all this hype about Pep Guardiola, they bring him in, and he fucking gets their asses relegated. And Everton, after having a terrible season, well, not they didn't have a relegation in terrible season, but they had a season that, you know, if a few more results had gone against them, they might have been in the relegation dogfight. And West Brom haven't been really a real factor in the relegation fight for a few seasons yet. Let's see, anyone gonna go up to higher rating? No, not unless Ojo's going up and dribbling is gonna shoot him up to 75, which I doubt it will. No, he didn't even go up because he got D. No, the closest I think was Pullet? Pullet would probably be the closest of those players. Oh, Sanchez wants a new contract. And the new youth players are in the house. I don't know what I'm gonna do with them, but hey, sure, why not? He could be okay. His ring is something to be desired, but hey, a few seasons out on loan will fix that. Same with you. Actually, he has a probably more promising future than the other guy. And Rossetti. Rossetti. Probably saying his name incredibly wrong, but hey, go with it. And there's my new signing. The new second team striker. And I've decided that come January, I'm going to recall the guy who's at Leeds, Mills. I'm going to recall Mills and send Brito out on loan instead. I kind of wish like there was a way I could negotiate with Leeds that I would take Brito back. I'd take Mills back and I would give them Brito. Oh, so Brito could fulfill the loan obligation that currently Mills is set to fulfill. Ojo, he's getting close to that 75, so not bad at all. Nope, no international management. Nope, not today. Stoke is the second game. I didn't realize how far away even the first game it was. Let's see. It's Afobe, who is the Wolves player, who's on five goals. Isn't he an ex-Arsenal player? Yeah, he is, isn't he? Or is that somebody else I'm thinking of? I'm gonna say that it is Afobe, but I might be wrong. I think it's Afobe. Again, like I said, I could easily be wrong. It wouldn't be the first time, and it damn sure won't be the last. Nice. Teamwork. I mean, he had to get a result against the always capable Stoke City.
Bolshide in the heart of defense. Jordan Shaqiri plays with Marko Arnautovic in the wide positions. And today,
their team hasn't changed that much since the start of the since I first started. They do have Classy,
Arnautovic,
who in real life is a Southampton player.
Jordy Classy. Marko Arnautovic.
He should have been at Southampton come the start of the at the very start, although I think his transfer went through too late and he wasn't at them. Maybe he was and they signed him from Southampton. Here is possible. And You know what, Phil? Don't bother jumping. Jumping is overrated.
Look at the amount of goals they scored. Top scorers.
Yeah, maybe they'd fancy themselves to grab one or two here.
Wolves have scored 7 goals, 5 of which have come from one dude.
I think, Alan, the home team need a win. A couple of draws in their last two games.
Spread out the goals more, huh? Oh, Wolves.
I think they do need that win just to give them a bit of confidence. Which...
Ronaldo! He's offside.
It's no goal. The flag's up.
I saw the flag.
A well-worked move, but denied by
the system. Way before. Or the aim across the ball in. The ball before it got to Ronaldo. I mean, we'll see. He wouldn't have raised it until I kicked it. Coutinho! Well, why didn't you do something fancy? I was kind of expecting maybe a fancy bicycle kick or a but instead he waited for it to come to his head. I mean, what a corner, so I guess it's okay.
Looking for win number 5 in succession.
Well, they almost come here as favourites, don't they, on form? So let's see if they can dominate possession.
Shawcross.
Yo, Neymar hunting down the ball. Rain.
Ricardo Rodriguez. Royce.
Marco Royce. Ah, why did I do skill? I never do skill. One time and instantly you mess up. Coutinho! Oh, why didn't he pass it to Neymar? Or who was the man at the edge of the box who I was hoping he would pass it to, but he passed it to Coutinho instead. Ed. Marco, I don't appreciate you taking.
Wonderful understanding. John Joe
not in ignoring me. And, actually pass it to who I tell you to pass it to. Who?
No impact
stupid
on the game.
Game.
Now they've got
Neymar.
In this part of the pitch.
Royce, for some reason, left it. He got it a second time. And he buries it. And it's 1-0. Ironically, number 16 scores in this 32nd minute.
Let's have another peek at that goal.
I like the defenders just freaking stood there. This guy even got megged. Ah, oh, you're a disgrace to my surname. And that's why yours has an I, you dumb prick. You don't deserve the correct spelling of the surname. And you Dutch. Dumbass.
Slip past his marker. Neymar.
Neymar. Ideally, that would have been.
Referee has blown and he's given the free
better. Kick. Her. Ideally. Hey. Passes go in real life. It's realistic. Right? It happens all the time.
Well, it is Liverpool's match.
You think it'd be easy to pass to another player in black instead of the ones in red and white, but hey, easy mistake to make. Neymar. Oh, Ronaldo goes for the bicycle kick. He shouldn't have even bothered, because he was never going to win that ball anyway. Good interception, Nathaniel.
That's a quick reaction from the thrower.
See, this is why Nathaniel Klein was our best defender last season. And he's probably going to have to be our best defender this season as well, because, like I said already, our defense is probably going to be worse than it was last season. Yay! He one step forward and 50 steps back. Hang on, I think there's someone at Liverpool's door. Oh, is it Newcastle? Hello, Newcastle. Oh, you're taking our spot, is it? Oh. Yeah. Where our transfers, I wouldn't bet against it.
Right into the middle.
That's how bad it is. That is how bad it is, ladies and gentlemen. I am legit scared for Liverpool. Our defense is terrible, and for some reason, some Liverpool fans, some other Premier League fans are saying we could be a contender. For what? Yeah, we have a strong offense, but you need a strong offense and a good defense to win a Premier League title. Liverpool are severely lacking in that defensive category. And strong offense, considering some of the her offenses that we're going to be competing against, yeah, let's not count our chickens before they hatch, okay? Are you freaking kidding me?
So, away we go at 1-1. Attacking play, good skill with the ball to beat a man. Gonna cross it. Good take by the goalkeeper, but no pressure.
Oh my God, Bale! See Ronaldo. You know, you see your buddy Ronaldo from Real Madrid. Pass it to him next time, you dumb mulch twit.
Stoke City want to make this change.
Termans, go Neymar, go. Oh, brilliant ball to Coutinho. Bury it! Yes, thank you, Phil. Oh, someone here is reliable. Oh, oh, thank God.
Just guiding it into the bottom right-hand corner.
Thank the FIFA God that my offense is reliable, because my defense seems to be taking some severe nightmares.
City are getting ready to make it.
Oh my God, no, 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 get that, get the fuck out of here. I don't care if it's a yellow, I don't care if it's red. Yeah, no, don't care.
It
stops them building an attack. Oh my God, why didn't, that was Jonjo Shelvey, are you kidding me? What's the point of having big players if they don't win freaking headers? Oh my God. Oh my God. What have I done? Thank you, Phil, again. Phil Coutinho is being the only one who's being anywhere reliable today in this match against Stoke. Come on. Ronaldo. Over to Nathaniel Klein. Would you believe it? Of all people to come from nowhere and hopefully wrap this game up.
Well, he's hit it hard and he's hit it first time, but perhaps the keeper could have got more on that.
3-1 the scoreline as we restart the game.
Nathaniel Klein continues his run, because that means he's scored at least one goal in every season so far.
Rafael Varane.
I can get a few goals with my defensive players. And Nathaniel's goal couldn't have come at a better time, if you ask me.
On to Ronaldo.
Go, don't stop. Ronaldo, who isn't challenged, and buries it. It. Stoke are done.
Ronaldo, and the way he's guided that to the left-hand side of the goal, where it's wonderful technique.
One team really on their game today, the other very off colour. He can cross it now.
Do not concede. What are you doing? Oh my God. Fucking park the bus. Hang on a second. Sorry, Phil. Open. They clearly need fucking help. CDM. Do I have a center back on the bench? I do. Who? Sorry, Neymar. Herbert. This is a freaking emergency.
position to spoil Liverpool's day, but they haven't looked like doing it because Liverpool haven't let them look like doing it. Liverpool want to make an alteration. They're going to bring a new player on. That's going to be a free kick.
Gives me the chance to get my new players onto the pitch. Coutinho is going off anyway, so that yellow card is pointless, referee.
Got a track record at times of poor disciplinary record, and
just so you know. Wow, that's got to be a red. I was on a counter attack. Oh, of course it's a yellow for them. Of course it's a yellow for them. Go fuck yourself, you daft, biased cunt. No, don't know the rules of the game. It doesn't matter anyway. Ronaldo scores, makes it 5-1, so you can take. He can buy his shit and shove it up your ass.
And two very well taken goals.
Oh, it's another beautiful free kick. Good to see someone other in my defense being completely asleep. Ronaldo sneaks. And not sure how the fuck they missed him, but hey, I'm not going to complain. Cristiano Ronaldo, who thoroughly ensures that this game is 100% over. And the referee emphasized that with the a full-time whistle. Thank the FIFA god that shit is over. I need to just take. I'm glad I don't have to play his career mode for a few days, because if I had to play it anymore or right now, I think I might absolutely snap. Because the players are playing like freaking idiots. So that's the episode. Thanks as always for watching. And smash the like button if you did enjoy it. Subscribe so you don't miss any future content from me. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.